You hand over the key.
Yes.
Where is the key?
You wait for me first. You are the CPC.
Which one? Aro. This one also hands over.
Bring, bring.
Doctor, I'm going to go first. So, I'm going to come soon.
You put it.
The thing was very clear. You are told to go home early. So when they told you that the private cars should remove, the benefit was very clear. His Excellency was very clear. You must be home by curfew. So if you are not there, that's a different thing altogether. Why camera now in the Miss Zokora? You have nobody to use.
Hand over, sir. Thank you so much.
Where is this one?
I'm here.
Talk about yourself.
Yes, I'm going to drop this gentleman.
Where is the gentleman you are dropping?
I finished dropping.
You are saying you're going to drop this gentleman. Who is your
gentleman?
There's nobody in the vehicle saying I'm going to drop this gentleman.
This gentleman?
Yes. That's when I phone jam.
Who gentleman is this? How does it Anani come with a perfume? Hand over your key.
Hand over. You age,
eh?
You age, age. Check. You have?
You
beer?
Yeah. This one you got?
Yeah.
You got this one?
Yeah. You beer 5.
Here.
Yeah.
Where are we going?
We are about, sir.
Clear this one.
The key.
This one, they are removing the key.
Yeah.
You get the key, you have food. Boss, hand over the key. And this vehicle, the remaining ones, I have space there. Yeah.
This one we clear. We are finished.
Yeah,
we have the key.
What is the driver for this one?
This table they have already taken us.
Is it locked?
Just take a picture.
I'm seeing the windows are open.
Even in here.
Okay.
They gave you the key, you even entered the vehicle. Now you should
be. I saw someone who was
repairing. Keep moving, sorry.
Repairing?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, where's the occupant of this one?
You didn't
even
see it. Come here.
UAM?
There were 75M?
Yes.
You have?
The
owner disappeared, so?
Yes. The question mark.
No.
upgrade the PC.
Yes, sir.
Show the DPC.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Who's the driver of this one?
There. Hold it there. Hold it there.
It's not there.
This one, sir.
Junior.
Which one is it? Land Rover. Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. I can maybe tell them to, because I'm in the field here. I'll explain the vehicle.
It's not there.
It's okay, sir. However,
this is the white chief. We are going to cut it off.
Where is the
driver of this one? It's okay,
it's right there. I have this one here. But you have it on your wrist?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And this one?
That one is gifted as charging. This one, that's how they're running away.
Check the other end.
Is it locked? You check whether it is locked.
Then check the RL.
We are remaining with the one.
He has moved it.
Are you for this car?
Yeah.
Hey, this is the one.
You are the one?
Yeah.
No, it's coming. Why are you going to the chimney?
Especially in those who are involved in the informal sector, are not observing the guidelines on social distancing. There are still those who are carrying facial masks in their pockets, and those who are drawing the facial masks below the chin and getting themselves exposed, and even putting the life of other Ugandans in danger. That is a habit we've observed. And we want to call upon the public that please, let's stick to the guidelines that we are given. If you feel you can't come out and wear a face mask or have a facial covering, then it's better you remain at home. Those who are not observing social distancing or physical distance, like we've observed in Chisenyi, in Owino, in Chikubo, Chiseka, Arua Park, and most of these urban centers, trading centers, as you move out of the city, you'll still see people gathered in groups of more than five and promoting very, very risky behavior in this period of the pandemic. Like my colleague has indicated, the cases continue to rise. And these are not very good signs for a country. We still need to see the curve flattening further. Although it is in an area involving truck drivers and those who came in contact with them, it is worrisome because we don't know what is in the community. The Joint Task Force has come out today to get to let the public or to populate the MOBI application that we do have. There are people who continue to call us at different levels, asking for the number of the DPC, so and so, asking for the number of the OCCID, or when he's seeking assistance, wherever they are. So we've come out today as we continue the fight against the spread of the COVID-19 pandemic to let the public know that the UPF, the Uganda Police Force mobile application, has expanded with 6 more features for that include areas of reporting crime. If you want to check your EPS ticket, if you're buying a car and you want to check the EPS ticket, you just go straight into the app and then you check the status of the EPS ticket. If there are any missing persons, loved ones who are missing, we have photos that are uploaded of missing persons on this mobile application that you can get to access and cross-check. Now, there are people who sometimes get themselves stranded, they're in danger, they're in need of assistance. The application will give you the nearest police station, whereby if you navigate, you find you can easily find your way to the nearest police station. And if at all somebody is also calling you from a distance, like in Busia or Tororo, you can search the nearest police station in Busia, and then you can refer that person there for assistance. The application of that very police station has the immediate contacts of the territorial commanders. If it is a division, a district, a police station, you'll be able to find the numbers, the contact numbers of the DPC, of the divisional or district CID officer, of the OC station. You'll also find the counter number that you can call so that you can get assistance. Instead of looking for the top managers, and then again we go back down to the lowest level. Those who have lost property, wherever we recover property in all these 1,600 stations, we do get to upload what has been lost and found on the application. When you enter, you can go through and try to trace for the lost property that is there. The lost national IDs, we take the records and then we send those national IDs to NIRA for further follow-up. So I want the community during this period to stay informed about the important UPF services, such as station locations, crime prevention, traffic issues. You can file your police report directly from the app. Like I indicated, you can access all police stations since it has a mapping of all police stations that can help a person seeking help to locate the nearest police and get assistance. So far we have, since the inception of this app, we have over 10,000 uploads since the inception, and those who are already using it have found it incredibly effective for police services in Uganda, including those who are in the remote and rural areas. Provided there is internet, you are able to, provided there is internet, it won't be very difficult for you to get assistance. You just get onto the system and then The response teams will be able to find you based on the app that this mobile app. So it will help someone who is in danger and who is in desperate need of an emergency services. So a quick look at the requirements. You simply need to download it from Google Play, where you can't upload it now from Apple, from the Apple version, because the smartphone app is still being developed. But those who have the Android version of the operating system, you can start using it. You need to have data, and you need to always indicate your name and contact. That is mandatory. Those who have emails can also indicate the email so that we can get to you through the email, but that one is optional. It is not mandatory. There are people who are behind this app at the command center and all these other locations who will interface with you on a one-on-one and always get back to you. So you just need to follow the prompts and get the necessary assistance. Now, we also want to further clarify, there are still people who had stickers, the 26 categories that were issued by the Ministry of Works and Transport. They are still calling us up to today due to the conflicting information and interpretations that are out there. We want to come out today to clarify that people who do have stickers, even though there is restriction on the use of private vehicles, and as we go forward, we are looking at developments regarding public transport. We want to inform them that their stickers are valid and they still need to continue using their stickers. Remember, the timing of movement still remains 6:30 up to 7 p.m. Now, we were simply guided that some of these stickers, why they are valid is for future reference. We don't know the developments that will come as we get to move forward. We never know, the disease may reach an extent where it may escalate and may involve maybe again rolling backwards. So it's important that people who do have their stickers keep them in case we are to get to roll back. We don't need to go into the categories because they know themselves. And I remember that even amongst those that had stickers, there were minibuses that were given stickers to transport staff at different workplaces and so on and so forth. So that's why it is still important. We conducted some operations this morning and they are still ongoing within the central business district areas. After getting complaints of people who are not complying with the guidelines and SOPs that were given by the Minister of Health, we still see acts of people gathering in numbers. There is a lot of movement, increased activity, if you go to the downtown areas, like I indicated of Owino. If you go to Chikuvo, you don't even have space. And we noticed that the managers of these areas and sectors are also not playing a very big role because they needed to work very closely with the other stakeholders of the City Council Authority, the Minister of Trade, together with the joint security agencies, to ensure that there is a controlled environment. There is controlled movement and there is controlled behavior in these places, something that we are not seeing. So we decided that we restrict some movements as of this morning, so that we can arrange for better harmonized and controlled settings within the central business district. Because if anyone contacts a carrier who is exposed, gets and mixes with these people, then you find that within very few minutes, a multitude of Ugandans who have come out to resume businesses will find themselves exposed, something that is not good.